A new aquarium was being built on the island of Sodor. It will feature many different sea creatures from all over the world. All the engines were very excited, including Thomas, for he had never seen so many sea creatures before. As he went to the docks, Thomas pulled next to James and Frankie, who was unloading fish plants. "Do you two need help?" asked Thomas hopefully. "No thanks," snorted James. "An engine like me doesn't need help." "Exactly," added Cranky. "Now get going and be a bother to someone else." Thomas felt hurt, so that's what he did. Thomas then puffed over to where Harvey was moving a bunch of small crates. "Do you need help with those, Harvey?" Thomas asked kindly.
"Oh, I appreciate the help," said Harvey. "But these crates are full of empty fish tanks, and they are very fragile. I'm sorry, Thomas. We just don't need you to be breaking anything, since Henry is coming over to collect them."
Thomas was even more upset, so he puffed sadly away. As he moved off, Thomas noticed two cars he had never seen before coupled to Salty on the next track. They were large, and Thomas could see through their sides. They were full of water. A large octopus was swimming in the rear car. Thomas was amazed. Then he pulled up to the front car. This one had a huge shark in it. The shark looked at Thomas and opened its mouth. It had rows of big sharp teeth. "Whoa!" gasped Thomas. Salty noticed this. "Amazing, aren't they? These critters from the deep, eh, Thomas?" he asked. "They are," said Thomas. "Are these for the aquarium?" "Boy, mate," answered Salty with a smile. "And it's at Tidmouth. It'll sure be fun having them here, don't you think?" Thomas was so pleased he forgot to be hurt. "I can't wait to tell Percy about them," he thought. "Maybe we can see them at Tidmouth." Just then, Henry rushed by. "Out of the way, you two! I'm in a hurry!" he puffed importantly. Thomas was hurt all over again. "Don't fret, Thomas," said Salty sympathetically. "Little engines can be mighty handy at times." "Thank you, Salty," sighed Thomas, "but I don't think I'll be much help here." So Thomas puffed away to collect his trucks to take to Maithwaite. As he was leaving, Thomas saw Percy coming in with the afternoon mail train. "Percy," Thomas started, "you've got to take a look at the cars that Salty is."
"Not now, Thomas," Percy interrupted. "I have to deliver this mail right on time. The mail can't deliver itself, you know."
Just as Percy passed Salty, there was the huge shark looking right at him. "Yikes!" Percy cried, and he shot forward. Harry was waiting for Harvey to clear his line when suddenly, everything happened at once.
"Look out, James!"
"Ah! Oh no!
Oh my!
Ah! Oh! Yuck!" Luckily, no one was hurt, but Percy was derailed after bumping into Henry, and his mail was spilt. Henry had crashed right into Harvey's fragile load, and now was shattered into a billion pieces. Harvey had bumped right into James, who was now covered in seaweed thanks to Cranky being startled by the bump. Salty had witnessed everything.
"Driver, go and find the nearest telephone," he exclaimed.
"I think I know a certain engine who can help clean up this mess."
"Right," said Salty's driver. As Thomas pulled into Maithwaite, the station master was waiting for him.
"Leave your cars here, Thomas," he said urgently. "There's an emergency."
"What happened?" asked Thomas.
"There's been an accident at the docks," the station master said urgently. "The lines are blocked, so you are to go back there and help clean up the mess."
"Right away, sir," whistled Thomas, and he set off back to the docks. When he got there, Thomas set to work. First, he helped pull Henry clear from the wreckage. Then he pulled Percy back onto the tracks while Harvey took care of the broken crates and broken glasses. Finally, he helped Harvey clean the seaweed off of James. "An engine like you doesn't need help," teased Thomas, "and you had one just now." All James said was, "Thank you." Once the mess was cleared up, the engine puffed away, blowing a turnkey whistle to Thomas for all his hard work. Salty rolled over to congratulate him.
"Well, Thomas, I knew you'd find some way to prove what a really useful engine you are," he said.
"I did," grinned Thomas. "And you're right, Salty. Little engines can be mighty handy at times." The two engines laughed and they rolled off to the aquarium. Thomas then looked back at the shark, who just happened to wink at him.